So, welcome everyone over here on the More Life channel. Let's package here this AV1 and LibHive stuff for PDF integration, as per the main channels. Summary, I should actually, in the other video, so much to rushing this here, is all the stuff, AVIF, I think, and was it here or somewhere else? And somewhere they had a good, maybe this was this image. I think it wasn't this. It was much better. But yeah, this image demonstration certainly looked pretty good. Or was it this? Maybe it was this. Oh, this was this. So if you compare this here, why do I even work on this? So this is supposedly kind of sort of even better than WebP. Here with this promotional stuff. So yeah, let's package this stuff, which is, by the way, so this has landed, was it Chrome? Yeah, so this has landed in Chrome, so that maybe your latest Google Chrome can already display AVIF stuff. And as I said in the more main channel, we want certainly want this for our scanned office documents and future PDF versions. Also, yeah, LibGIMP, but LibGIMP, the latest GIMP actually didn't compile for me so much too. Did you already update this? But yeah, it doesn't. So this is the usual stuff of whatever library and stuff going on there. So yeah, welcome everyone. So the packaging was a little bit boring, but if you have questions or stuff, always ask me. We could, by the way, start already with opening this TMux. And then build, I think I had this updated of GIMP fan, and yeah, I think maybe I have, but I'm pretty sure that didn't build. When did I build it into the system? Already unlock GIMP, yeah, of course this didn't build, of missing JSON, this, yeah, Python 3, actually, you know what, maybe they are so stupid to check for, can it be that they check for, maybe I do this another day, I do this already, yeah, maybe they have hard-coded Python 3 for whatever. Anyway, Marco writes, supported in RTX 3K, 6K, something only, no, on the newest GPUs. Yeah, so this is if you want to do this in hardware, but even JPEG, you do not necessarily decode in hardware, so it will, of course, just decode in software like LibJPEG and stuff, so not the, but also the, so I think the latest Intel and AMD, upcoming AMD silicon as well, but we can see this later. Android, lib reference, let's find where this maybe is, AVN's codec library, AOM, maybe this one, is this the same as that one, maybe it is, maybe it isn't. Let's see, so this looks like maybe Git Perl, JSON, something, but yeah, of course you don't need the hardware codec just to use this. What, zero text? Why don't, no releases? And no, why do they not have releases and text? What, should this not be at least 0.1? Can't make this stuff up. Here then, it's a little bit inconvenient without, to be honest. Yeah, why does this not, does it git clone like this? It git clones like this. We also need LibHive. So one is a codec similar to, what would be a good example? Even JPEG, but at JPEG most people don't realize this as much as that there is a JPEG codec and a JPEG container format. But theoretically, even TIFF, you can put JPEG in TIFF, which is also highly incompatible and stuff. But if you wanted, you could. Ha! Version 191, fixed compilation in C++ wrappers like release engineering as its finest. Testing, recurring theme on this channel, testing, testing, more testing. I guess I have not packaged that yet. let's see what happens, what configure, also the recurring theme of what are they using as CMake. CMake, what happens of build and source not supported anymore because nah, object dir, CMake. Let's also, I think I didn't package that yet. And lib hive, and yeah, of course I didn't package that. Where do we place it? Maybe in, do we have, if multimedia, do we have image? Maybe not. Where do we have image magic and exact graphic, obviously. Yeah. I guess that is where we could place that. And if you're wondering, so I need to do it anyway, then we can also hang out here together. Let's just copy lib or what else. Let's copy maybe this lib5 desk. If you're wondering why we do this, so maybe you learn something, maybe you just want to hang out and stuff, because I need to do it anyway, and then this is how much time you spend doing it anyway, and then we can also live stream it, because faster. Hey, they use an amazing download link, not like other projects that just links a version 191 something thing. And yeah, odd stable, so we need that. No prefix, I guess we don't really need here. License might be wrong. I usually first compile this and then see how it is going. Do they have a nice website? But maybe not, whatever, I guess. Oh, it's an ISO, everyone, file format. What file format decoder? I think, yeah, file format, I guess. Yeah, and SSF for the best compression. So why do I want this in PDF? Because certainly we want the best compression currently possible. And something five format decoder and encoder. Is it too long? Maybe this fits. And yeah, certainly we only settle for the best and nothing less. Ruler of, speaking of the best, I think I need to enable the ruler by default sometime soon. After 20 years, I guess it's finally time. Also, yeah, currently possible. This usually doesn't age. What if I press now? This usually doesn't age well, so you put this text in here and then it's here for 2 decades. Yeah, what if I pasted there? Nobody screaming there. Some drop frames, 4 points, so much to screaming with such an high bitrate in. Then what if I press now? Lib5. Who's the author? Someone, something with API compiling. He's also David, by the way, adding David decoder for... Yeah, so you see some stuff already starts to support this, even GNOME. Something with GDK Pixmap also includes GDK Pixmap loader. So yeah, the problem with this stuff always included is that it has really many dependencies. It is always a little bit annoying. Where is here? Anyway, let's first try to... here's also libhive, then let's use that. And as you see, libde, what, 265 of here, this patent and compared stuff. Not for me. Who's the author? Is this an author of? Yeah, of course they need cookies. Why does such an open website need cookies? I have, what? Where to find them? What the heck? You're freaking kidding me. Yeah, open source libraries in 2020 have contact forms. You had me at contact forms. Is there some author somewhere? But so this is also, okay, this is LGPL. By the way, was an author something. Yeah. This is always a probably did an author file. So this is always a little bit annoying that also they have even a configure if you wanted that. So what I've usually resort to is then clicking on some primary file and it's really Struktur-AG because reason. Ever heard of this Struktur-AG though? So yeah, the problem is this, the recurring theme here, previously configure Mac install, nowadays not only whatever. And we could actually see how this goes, but I have the feeling a decade ago or two, you could just build package that and you could rely on configure Mac install doing its thing, but yeah, not so in 2020. What is that now? Building is not, did I in MKD? I did this on a run make from, I thought I see also what run. Why does it want AOM? What is this? Was it not built within the AOM source tree? Is not what they want, even MK. They want it even not inside there? Are they completely kidding me? No, what? What the heck is even happening here? Nothing to commit. Let's try that again. Maybe this was some cached stuff. Yeah, it was some cached. I mean, can't make this stuff up. It's hilarious in my opinion. So let's see how this is going. Also, we have 32. And obviously, libhive, or at least it starts to do something. But yeah, also, maybe we should config default config temp fs to be able to better debug this. There also, for those who just hang out here for the Linux content stuff, there is a new Linux kernel 5.9, but you know us, we wait usually for the first point release because yeah, bug fixes and regressions. Cheers. So this surprising or unsurprisingly even did something. AOM, DEC and ENG. So this is more than I thought. Then let's wait a second. AOM, probably graphic and SVNMKDR AOM. So the name is a little bit nah. AOM, seriously, who thought that is a good name for anything? AV1. Is it Alliance Open Media or what? Mozilla AOM? Alliance for Open Media. Alliance for Open Media. Reference implementation Mozilla. Why is this, by the way? Or maybe we click here and see what we get there. Getting started membership. They also have download of 2020 fancy websites, but Bitstream reference code base. Yes, by the way, what do we have here? GitHub, libafif, and AOM Media, Google Source, AOM. So maybe this is slightly different than the. Can never have too many reference implementation for this, I guess. Do they have text version 2.0. At least they have text in contrast to the Mozilla one. And here's an amazing tar snapshot. Do they also have a proper, but yeah, you see how much time this is, in my opinion, also really ridiculous that you need to research here. What is the best download URL? Well, as certainly, yeah, don't criticize your free horse here, but It's like, 20 years ago we had websites with a tarball, now we have just some git export thing, and that's it apparently. But yeah, we can also download this, although this file name certainly sucks a little bit, but nah, probably that's what we get in 2020. AOM, copy, like OpenJPEG again, because, or what was the other? The other was, what did we just package, ilib5? And AOM desk. So the good thing is, even if this doesn't become an ISO standard for PDF, which I hope it will, because otherwise we might end up with H.265, which probably, as I said, none of us wants. Nah. Then anyway, we need this for completeness in our open source distribution here, and also open source packages, GIMP, ImageMagick, and so on. And so this would be, oops. But yeah, this is just if yeah, so much to, can you quickly just do this? I mean, you already sit here 1 hour just collecting all the stuff. And well, certainly granted, if you just wanted to YOLO that on macOS and Windows, then you just download it and configure Mac install. But we have a little bit higher standards, and once it's also in our Linux distribution. So AOM, so let's AOM overwrite this here to 200 tar gset and call this 200 BSD, I don't know, something off. This was just an HDMI capture dongle, official release off. But it's also lib AOM, maybe we should. What is here? The license of first official release include something something. Oh, wait a second. This was, wait, did I not click on license? I thought there was. Ah, yes, patents. So this is BSD-ish, MIT-ish, something. Maybe we rename it then. Also, yeah, then we can, well, theoretically, yeah, for this it doesn't matter too much. For the download, it is in an AOM repository, so wait a second, theoretically we can also AOM media, not that this website would be the particularly most amazing, but whatever. And yeah, let's maybe, did I probably. And this was, what was it even? Yeah, you know what? Let's first download it. And so one is libhif is the container sync libtiff of packing whatever. And the other, also, wait a second. Other, okay, this is correct. Build package, let's see what happens. Probably not much. And what do we have here of something libhif? What? We might, okay, what did it do? Let's see what did it do automatically. Running configure, maybe it did this through PNG, U32, hive encode, nah. Libhive, was it not CMake? It had also CMake. Some strange did the CMake thing did build, didn't it? What does it want here of theoretically, is this just some, where is it even, examples? Well, theoretically we could disable the examples, but test go, is this a go example or This is somehow a mix between 32 parallel, because then you have so much stuff between the actual breakage and in general 2020 error diagnostic stuff. All recursive in. Have test go off. So then maybe can we disable go or disable go. There we go. I only hope I didn't. Problem is, I kept. This is a problem with this Unicode space stuff. I kept shift pressed and then end up with Unicode. Non-breaking spaces in there. Cannot access AOM. What? What the heck is this? This is hilarious. This extracts as directly a tar bomb. It can't make this stuff up. 2020, your stuff extracts like a tar bomb. But we can work around this. Our system doesn't care too much. Libaom. Oh, wait a second. Graphic libaom. And so we need two things. So apparently we need to tell our build system like source dir equals that, that should do it, and otherwise cmake of all of this, and we need something like cd of this. Apparently somehow, probably I should make this somehow a standard that if that is detect, like cmake is detected, then that we don't have this in all packages. Also, I don't quite get what the fuss is about building outside this, and that's it. This would give us anything of value, but So libhive build, libhive. So this looks also surprisingly, it built here this libpxbuf loader, so that this would work. This gives you this hive conversion example stuff. And certainly libhive headers and so on. So another package we got ourselves here by IDM cache libhive cache. And I said this before, if you want to support us so that I have more work on microkernel, PS3, SGI Octane, and other fun stuff, then send patches in, right? And I don't need to package this stuff. So probably do we need more of, actually, I've filled already quite some stuff in there. Surprisingly. So let's commit that. Also, probably maybe there's some. Let's check the cache and yeah, for example, this shouldn't be in there. Somehow this is my local build of this. Anyway, so the commit libhive, another package. Maybe it cross compiles, maybe it doesn't. Probably looks relatively, maybe I should BSD license, I always MIT license, or maybe this is too close. BSD, I guess. Original, let's see, this is distribution. What does MIT look of permission? Darn. Libhive license, what exactly is that? View license, license, U license. Oh wait, this is LGPL. What did I look there previously? Oh, maybe I did write the LGPL. Certainly that shouldn't be that misleading. Maybe the other was. Okay, so this builds, except it installed wrong. So mine rf lib aom. And let's see, var id unlock, what did it run? Maybe we need a running some prefix because did I still have this here? So cmake prefix of install prefix. Do we not have this as default? Maybe not. libaom. CMake install prefix like that. Maybe you also need libdir though. I wonder if we really don't have this in there, but maybe we don't. I slightly wonder, I rather would want this in extra cconf op, but yeah, so probably the CMake stuff we need to overhaul completely extra conf opt. This is not yet ideal, but it's not like too many packages would use this. Oh no, I deleted this already, unfortunately. Oh no, we have one already here. All right, because this was a build error. Let's check. Unfortunately, I have the feeling we might need a library path thing. Where do they they at times have this hard coded, unfortunately. Here is some libdir of maybe, maybe not. Maybe we try object dir. So it has some libsibc4. So this is install user local. That obviously is not amazing. It's surprising yes, libsibc4 through whatever. So prefix, how did it determine that install location? Static library files. Nah, not sure where it gets the slip 64 from. No, it's a recurring theme of wasting my time with build systems because I can never have too many of those. So this is probably all we need for getting started. Maybe we spend, as usual, some more people tune in. So longer we live stream, we could spend some extra minutes. It's probably all I need. Maybe I only need for this PDF research and stuff, and certainly I also need to create some test cases and examples of showing the amazing state-of-the-art compression of this stuff to the working group. Also probably I shouldn't short like this with the latest garbage world news of near. Maybe I managed not to show this, so t2sde Linux YouTube. Never too much shameless self-promotion, otherwise people don't tune in. So it's probably all I need. I hope we can, what prefix? Nah, we have done there something stupid. Maybe we shouldn't, yeah, okay, maybe it, alright, it's not running this with evil, but certainly we need set in double quotes for that to expand. Or actually maybe we, okay, whatever, really, it needs to be better another day anyway. Did I deinstall this? So, alright, Python 3. So let's try this GIMP, because certainly we want GIMP buildable. We anyway need to do some T2 homepage work soon, so that our homepage doesn't look so decade old up and done. Let's already change in here because we know already this will anyway not build because it didn't build the last time. Let's see, Python 3 in configure. No, Not sure then why. So the error is most likely Python too old. So libarm now it finally built. Let's so commit this. In case you're wondering why this built so fast, previous main channel, Epic, fat ripping, AMD Ryzen 3950X, in case you were wondering why developers need stuff like that. Or ADM, not a paid advertisement, just outstanding stuff we have here. libaom cache for the dependencies. What? Okay, we also need to fill this a little bit still. libaom. This is the right one. So let's grab here some text, cross compiling. Yeah, yeah, something. Do they not have some nice? Why do they not start with some nice promotional text? Testing the library. They really think everyone knows what it is, huh? Okay, let's copy here from FFmpeg 2020. FFmpeg text is better than the Google one. The something relative free. And yeah, you had me at relative free, not the hundreds of patterns of X of H26 whatever. AV1 video codec is this sort of Bali 4 the encoder for the reoccurrence. Certainly don't need two times. Also 2020, our summary is better than some upstream stuff. So can save up to 30% bitrate compared to VP9 or H265, in case you were wondering why I'm so thrilled about this and want to promote that. And maybe something. Also, 50% over A. So how state-of-the-art and outstanding is it? 50% over H264, which obviously is also a decade old, but yeah. Is the something, also here, best with some Unicode, copyright signs or whatever. Royalty free. But again, from this is just the beginning, then I need to write some hours, if not days, of work and testing of PDF glue of not existing stuff, like basically writing standard text and proof of concept stuff, which most likely will not do live on camera. But as usual, leave me in the comments below what you want to see more or less and so on. But yeah, let's we are not yet done. Theoretically we could test this again. What is happening here? So Python something version. So yeah, I really wonder why they say here version too old. Obviously, wait a second, Python version is 3.8. I wonder how this can be too old. 2020, even this stuff fails in the most creative ways possible. What do they do here? Something. Where is Python? Also, I wish this error would be like last and not in the middle. This is really strangely done. Import the strings by, what the freak, are you kidding me? What does he even freaking doing here? So they test PyGDK or what, checking? What is it? Oh no, this what, checking whether Python 3 version, Python 3 import this split string, what the heck? Well, theoretically, maybe I don't have Python, or do I have Python? I have Python 3, what the heck? Python 3, split strings by, and what the heck? What the freaking heck, are they even freaking trying there? Yeah, a decade ago you had a simple version check, in 2020 you have some freaking unreadable Python code. libaom. And does it really use Perl? Or maybe it used Perl. Could be that it used Perl. libaom. Darn, there's some spaces, because this is also why we have this in red, otherwise nobody would notice and our stuff would be as white space damage as a lot of other projects, but certainly we don't want that. That probably looks relatively okay-ish, I would think. So if you find typos, send me a patch and leave them in the comments below and similar such stuff. And so let's figure out this GIMP stuff, because nah, Python 3 what's but it could be that this conflicts with PyGDK stuff, maybe. Oh, wait a second, maybe it wants split strings, convert numeric, append, what is it doing here? So it's running this program. I wonder if, or do they only support Python 2? I mean, in 2020 is not present in, and range returns an integer. You had me at not present in test Python, garbage checking also. Ah, darn, wait a second. Yeah, also if this would be my language, I wouldn't made it so incompatible. Python, what is it, probably just this, huh? What? Import this, min version list something, for something, this exit, ah. Okay, zero. Do they want Python 2? But I heard that people complain that GIMP still needs JDK 2, so don't color me surprised. That this may need Python 2. Let's see what happens. Cheers. So we can certainly, so next I need to actually get some real work done, not only playing here around with some YouTube prompts with delay libaom. So what did we get here? So we want to encode stuff. So we have AOM decode and encode. Maybe we can use this directly. Then what programmers do need to learn about the API, either by reading the freaking documentation. Also we want encoder. So what do they have to say here, encoder? Also, yeah, 2020, of course, C. Probably not even something. What do they have here? C++, maybe not. So yeah, reference codec stuff in C, because it is so 90s, and security and stuff, and you guessed it. Okay, fine, I probably need to retrieve freaking documentation. I wonder AOM, and we want mostly encode, or actually we want both, but what file names does it support? What codecs does it support? Does it support maybe a RAW? Maybe codecs to use. Anyway, so it actually continues. So apparently maybe they only support Python 2, because why should they support something? And they want freaking way more dependencies, or missing dependencies, bubble giggle. Apparently can we tail in 20 or 40 of emerge missing only. So this is, in my opinion, getting a little bit out of hand with all those dependencies. Oh, did I even copy them? In 2020, you can never have too many. I wonder. But this is funny. They have here, why is this error different than this glib networking? But yeah, let's. Do I not have libjpg, or do I have two? I slightly. Are they probably we don't have my paint. I mean, can't mix this stuff up. My paint brushes. What the heck? Not even sure if the PNG. What version did I had installed? I'm not updating this on a daily basis. Yeah, let's. Well, Epic Threadbreaking, AMD Ryzen stuff can build a while. So also, yeah, obviously this fails because. So yeah, my opinion, leave me the comments below. For my taste, these dependencies are a little bit out of getting a little bit out of hand. For my taste, a little bit too many dependencies, but yeah. Yeah, also, and then this stuff doesn't just build because, I mean, okay, this is shared files, this is our own shared file stuff that we should probably patch and work around with, but yeah, look at what random stuff stuff fails. Also, this is XMLPO, whatever. Also, yeah, stuff, I mean, if you were wondering, I have the stuff in user X11R7, there, also still check for stuff in X11R6, but yeah, also in the rect dependencies, it theoretically could use an optional plugin stuff wherever. But you really wonder what's up here with error, so project directory not found, glib rep file not. I mean, I certainly have glib, this is somewhat hilarious. This is glib. Whereas glib, well, it's okay, it is a significant higher version because obviously it's not building GNOME stuff daily. So yeah, I get back to work. I hope you learned something. But yeah, this is also what all the distributions write. Another day in Seattle, in California. Also, this is glib mix. Subcommand of why does this fail? Maybe I should actually reinstall my system. Ah, this is, I've seen this before. This is hilarious. Maybe I should rebuild the glibc or something. What could possibly go wrong? Could something possibly go wrong? Yeah, this comes, this installation is super old. This comes from your rolling release distribution, and yet 5 years old, or soon, not yet, but soon 5 years old of rolling release updates here live on this channel, and then eventually some stuff has some minor inconsistencies. Anyway, hope you learned something. See you soon for all the other exotic videos to come. I have some codecs to test and so on. Have a good day, and I hope you learned something.